Do you know 40% of the people are overweight and 13% of the people are obese globally? Do you know 135 million people in India are obese? Do you know obesity is one of the major contributing factors for the development of chronic disorders like diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, musculoskeletal disorders like osteoarthritis and various cancers? Do you know the faulty dietary habit is responsible for obesity, diabetes, and this metabolic syndrome? If you want to know which is the best diet, how I should eat, if you want to keep yourself physically fit and reduce your belly fat, then watch this video till end. And I'm going to discuss A to Z about diet in this short video. Point number one, the incidence of obesity, diabetes are increasing exponentially all over the world. Initially, it was thought that caloric imbalance was responsible for obesity and diabetes. It means the obesity is because of eating excess calorie and doing less exercise. But according to new research, this theory is not true to a certain extent. The new theory says that the causes of obesity, diabetes is because of hormonal imbalance called as hormonal theory of obesity. And it is found that excess insulin, insulin resistance and excess cortisol are responsible for obesity and diabetes and metabolic syndrome. Now, why there is increase in incidence of insulin resistance? Because we are eating refined carbohydrate, refined wheat, excess sugar, lot of processed food, lot of packaged food, lot of high fructose corn syrup, cold drinks. Okay, so because of this, the level of insulin is increasing. And as we are eating more frequently, 5 times, 6 times, 7 times per day, it is causing insulin resistance. So excess insulin and insulin resistance is responsible for obesity and diabetes. And excess cortisol because of chronic stress is also a contributing factor for the development of obesity and diabetes and metabolic syndrome. So what food we should eat? There has been a lot of research done, which is the best diet. You might have bombarded with advice like eat low fat diet, eat low carbohydrate diet, eat ketogenic diet, eat high protein diet. Okay, so there has been research done on various cultures regarding their dietary pattern. For example, Eskimo eat 80 to 90% of their food containing fat. The Maasai tribe in Africa consumes 80 to 90% protein. The Okinawa state people in Japan eat 80% of carbohydrate. Still, the incidence of chronic disorders like obesity, diabetes, and metabolic syndromes are very negligible in this population. But when this population started eating so-called as Western diet, containing excessive sugar, highly processed carbohydrate, highly processed wheat, animal protein, packaged industrialized food, the incidence of obesity, diabetes, and metabolic syndrome increased exponentially. So excess fat, excess protein, or carbohydrate is not a problem. The way we are eating is a problem. So fat, protein, and carbohydrate is not responsible for obesity and diabetes, but refining of the food, industrialization of food, eating excess sugar, eating packaged food, and eating too frequently is responsible for the development of obesity and diabetes. So what food is the best for your health? So you should eat unprocessed homemade food consisting of cereal, pulses, fruits, vegetable, dry fruits, yogurts. So eat all the food which is prepared at home. you should avoid eating excess sugar because sugar is a poison. You should avoid packaged food which contain excess sugar and salt and preservative and coloring agent. You should avoid food containing trans fat. You should avoid animal food. And you should avoid all the food which is prepared by the industry. Okay. How you should eat. Frequent eating is also responsible for the development of insulin resistance. So you should eat 2 to 3 times per day within a short window of 8 hours. Okay, so you should eat, have a breakfast, lunch, and dinner by 6 o'clock. The way our ancestor used to eat. Our ancestor used to eat before sunset. Because if you eat beyond 6 o'clock, the incidence of obesity and diabetes increases, because after 6 o'clock, you are inactive and excess calorie is stored as a fat. So eat before 6 o'clock. If it is not possible, then try to skip 2 dinner per week. Do intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting is the important and only way you can reduce your belly fat. Okay. So eat within a short window of 8 hours. You have to walk after eating. Okay. You should avoid food which is prepared with the help of antibiotic or giving a lot of added chemicals. You should avoid food which is grown with the help of fertilizer. Try to eat food which is grown on an organic farm. So, dear friend, if you eat unprocessed, homemade, plant-based, vegetarian diet, and if you eat 2 to 3 times per day within a short window of 8 hours and do intermittent fasting, then you will take your health in your own hand. You will reduce your belly fat and you will keep yourself away from these chronic disorders like obesity, diabetes, heart disease, and cancer. Thank you so much. Implement this principle, which is very easy, and change your life. Thank you so much.